this record, I'm trying to pull together my sort of indie guitar background with the soul and jazz music that I've sort of grown up and been influenced by, and I feel happy with the record because I feel like it pulls together the two sides of who I am. You know, I don't feel like I'm being forced to like do one thing or do another. I feel like the music really comes together and those styles complement each other. You know, to me it's just heavy, and I wanted it to be heavy. I wanted it to feel more intense. I wanted it to have layers. I wanted it to have contrasts. And when I was going into the record, I thought, you know, I wanted to write all the songs myself, write all the melodies, all the lyrics, all the music. And then, you know, I knew I wanted to co-produce it, so I was really lucky to find Steve Brown and to work with Steve Chrysanthou, who I'd worked on my first album with. I really wanted it to be myself, you know, I wanted it to be self-expression, I wanted it to be intimate and raw and emotional, and so for that reason I just knew that I wanted to, you know, be involved in the production and the sound of it and run it, I guess. I want to run it. Going over to Abbey Road, which is somewhere where I love to visit when I'm in London. Last time I was there, I was playing with Herbie Hancock. He worked with Joni Mitchell on this album called The Joni Letters. It was all different people covering Joni Mitchell songs, and they asked me to do the song River. I kind of messed up my part quite a lot of times because his improvising was so incredible, and then Wayne Shorter was there and he was playing saxophone, and every single time I did it, he did a different solo, and I just found myself sort of totally caught up in what he was doing and just watching the solo, and then I'd realised, oh no, I'm meant to come in. But getting to play live at Abbey Road with Herbie Hancock was just an amazing experience. I've just left Music Bank, where I've been rehearsing, and now we've come over to Abbey Road, which is one of the most amazing studios in the world and definitely in London, so I wanted to come and speak to you. Till then I wasn't alive, I longed for you like the love said moon pulls the tide. So I peeled off my skin. I feel like I've loved music since I was born. You know, I grew up in a house full of music. You know, neither of my parents played instruments, but they played a lot of records. And my mum used to sing, my grandma sings, used to sing in like working men's clubs before I was born. So I feel like, yeah, I always loved music, and I guess I got picked out to do stuff, you know, early on at school, like got a violin that was that size, you know, when I was six or something. And so I feel like I've had really good opportunities. I feel like music's kind of sought me out. People have found me and helped me and given me this thing to express myself. So I'm really grateful to music for that. Found music important to me. When I was a teenager, I was in a band, and I felt like an outsider, and I found this music that was outside of music, you know, that was led by Kurt Cobain and Veruca Salt and Belly and all the people who didn't subscribe to the mainstream, didn't feel part of it, didn't share the values, didn't want to dress that way, didn't want to speak that way and aspire to those things. You know, so for me as a teenager, and especially as like a working class teenager in Britain, it was this other voice, you know, especially like being a girl, you know, there's this other female voice, and people like Courtney Love and Bjork and Martina Topley Bird, who were saying something different, and they were sort of demonstrating a certain kind of female power and female beauty and assertiveness that I thought, oh yeah, you know, I really relate to that. I hadn't seen it before in popular culture, and I guess part of starting my band was that I wanted to express myself, I wanted to add my voice to everyone else's voices, but, you know, I felt like I didn't really fit in, but this was music for people who didn't fit in. On the album, I play electric guitar and acoustic guitar, I play the auto harp, play a bit of glockenspiel, play tons of glockenspiel. You know, I had to be sort of restrained from putting glockenspiel on any more songs, like I think 5 or 6 songs is plenty. But I really love instruments that you can kind of get your hands on, or you know, things where it doesn't seem like a real complicated process to make the sound.
Have a look, this is an instrument I got.
Got it in LA.
I had to carry it back on the plane like this, but it's incredible. It's a marxophone, which I'd never heard of. I'm using an auto harp in this band for this for the song called The Sea, but this is incredible. It's amazing. And then these are like sprung hammers, so you can do single hits with them, or you can just really nice thing to play. I really like writing on stuff that isn't the guitar, because I just like to be able to find my way accidentally around instruments and come up with things. You know, I'm not a really technical songwriter, so I feel like this will help me. This is going to help me for one song, you know, and that's all it needs to be. So I'm going to have fun messing about with it.
I used to feel like